हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डिजी इंटीग्रिटी. वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 44. ओप्पो हैज लॉन्च इट्स F19 स्मार्टफोन इन इंडिया. लेट्स सी सम ऑफ द की स्पेसिफिकेशंस एंड प्राइसेस ऑफ दिस मोबाइल. द की स्पेसिफिकेशंस इंक्लूड इट कम्स विद 6.43 इंच फुल HD प्लस AMOLED डिस्प्ले. इट रन्स ऑन स्नैपड्रैगन 662 प्रोसेसर एंड इट हैज 128 GB ऑफ स्टोरेज. एंड इट ऑल्सो कम्स विद 5000 mAh बैटरी विद 33 W फास्ट चार्जिंग सपोर्ट. Oppo F19 price in India is ₹18,990 for the 6GB of RAM and 128GB storage model and will be available in Prism Black and Midnight Blue color option. You can pre-order the phone now and the first sale is on April 9. Oppo has unveiled two smartphones as part of its A-series lineup for buyers. The company has launched the Oppo A74 4G and Oppo A74 5G devices that pack octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon chipset. Oppo A74 specifications also include a 5000 mAh battery and that supports fast charging, and it also comes with 90Hz refresh rate display. More importantly, both the devices run on ColorOS version based on Android 11 operating system. HP has officially announced the HP Chromebook 11A in India. The laptop is currently the cheapest Chroma OS product in the country. Let us take a look at its specifications, features, price and availability. HP Chromebook 11A sports a 11.6-inch LED backlight LCD panel with a resolution of 1366x768 pixels. It is powered by MediaTek MT8183 processor coupled with 4GB of DDR4 RAM and 64GB of storage. If needed, the storage can be further expanded up to 256GB storage via included 3-in-1 card reader SD, SDHC and HDXE. Since the laptop runs on Google Chrome OS, it also supports Android applications and Linux application. Other features on this notebook include full-size keyboard, 720p webcam, dual speakers and dual microphone, Google Assistant and 37 Wh battery. Chromebook 11A is priced at ₹21,990 in India. It is already up for sale on Flipkart. It should also be sold by HP online store and selected offline retailers in the coming days. After banning Chinese application, which led to the formation of Indian counterparts, the Indian government is gearing up to announce a Desi version of voice assistants like Siri and the Google Assistants. The government has commissioned the creation of master app platform called Umang, which will answer voice-based queries like what's the status of my password renewal and what is the balance in my PF account. The queries will require a voice command, hey Umang, and will function like Siri, Google Assistants or Alexa do on smart speaker system. Vivo X60 series launched in India last month, comprising of the Vivo X60, X60 Pro and X60 Pro Plus. Now it looks like the brand seems to have started working on Vivo X70 series already. There are some leaks about Vivo X70 series. It may come with 4500 mAh battery and which supports 66 W fast charging. And it also comes with Samsung E4 AMOLED display. It may run on Snapdragon 888 chipset. As per the leaks, Vivo X70 series launch will happen in June this year. Vivo is working on their new smartphone, Vivo Next 5. The smartphone specifications and key details have been leaked. The Next 5 will come with 6.78-inch quad-curved display. That if this device will launch in two variants. One of the two models will have a 100 display camera and other standard model will come with a punch-hole display. WhatsApp is finally been testing chat history transfer between Android and iOS devices. You will soon be able to transfer WhatsApp chat data from Android to iOS and vice versa. Transferring chats between both platforms is not officially possible as of now. The feature is currently in the testing phase. Lenovo's next gaming phone will also stick with the design optimized for landscape use. Lenovo is all set to launch the Legion Phone 2 Pro on April 8th in China. The company has been teasing various hardware for the upcoming phone on its Weibo account for a while now. Now ahead of the official announcement, some leaked photos of Legion 2 Pro has surfed online. As you can see in the photos, the Legion Phone 2 Pro is sticking to the same landscape orientation concept as its predecessor, with the USB Type-C port at the pop selfie camera and lineup on the right side. On the back, we can see the dual rear camera setup, an active cooling fan and a Legion Star logo sandwiched between the two symmetrical white squares. DJI has been known to be working on a new drone for a while. A new leak has revealed the supposed renders of the upcoming Air 2S drone along with the few key specifications. The Air 2S from the popular drone maker features a 20-megapixel shooter, which is an improvement from the 12-megapixel sensor that can be found in the previously launched Mavic Air 2. Reliance Jio and Qualcomm Snapdragon has joined hands to host a gaming tournament on the Jio Games platform. The companies are calling it the Call of Duty Mobile Access Esports Challenge. The game tournament is a free to participate, which includes solos and 5-on-5 team plays. The company has also announced that the winning team of the Call of Duty Mobile Access Esports Challenge will get a prize pool of 25 lakhs. Jio has announced that it will live stream the entire esports tournament on its Jio TV, Esports HD channel and Facebook Watch and the Jio Games YouTube channel. According to the official website, the registration of the Solos tournament ends on April 11, 2021 at 9 PM IST. However, you still have time until April 30, 2021 to register for 5-on-5 team matches. The qualifier matches will kick off the June 11, 2021 and the finals will be held on June 20, 2021. Qualcomm hires former HMD Global Executive Juho Sarvakis for key position. Jim Cathay, a senior vice president and president of Qualcomm Global Operations, announced on Twitter that Juho Sarvakis is joining the company and Sarvakis will become the vice president and president for the company's North America business. He said on Twitter, "I am really excited to look forward to joining the amazing team Qualcomm." Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.